Well, overseas now, and for the first time since the war in Gaza began, the UN Security Council has finally passed a resolution demanding an immediate ceasefire and the unconditional release of all hostages. The United States this time did not use its veto power to block the vote. That has infuriated the Israeli government.
A key diplomatic development, critics say, was long overdue.
The draft resolution has been adopted.
14 Security Council members, including Russia, China and the UK, voted for a resolution demanding a ceasefire for the rest of Ramadan and the immediate unconditional release of all hostages.
Your demand for a ceasefire without conditioning it on the release of the hostages not only is not helpful, but it undermines the efforts to secure their release.
In a significant shift, the United States abstained from this vote. It has used its veto power to block the past three.
This must be a turning point. This must lead to saving lives on the ground.
The resolution isn't binding. Israel's war on Hamas can and will continue, but the Israeli Prime Minister is still furious, accusing the United States of abandoning its policy in the UN. In response to the vote, Benjamin Netanyahu immediately cancelled a planned visit to Washington by Israeli officials.
We're kind of perplexed by this. The Prime Minister's office is choosing to create a perception of daylight here, when they don't need to do that.
A growing rift between once rock-solid allies as the war approaches its sixth month. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First.